Okay. Can you able to see my sharing?
Yeah.
Okay. So today we will start with the BRF, which is a new update in S/4HANA for output management. Okay. So let me open my notepad. Okay. So you all know that we are using a NACE transaction, right? For a condition technique, using a condition technique.
Yes. So this will be replaced by BRF plus, is it?
Yeah. So condition technique, it's basically we have. So what is there in the condition technique is we create a condition table. We create access sequence. Right, and assignment of access. Access sequence is assigned to condition table. Okay. So then we have condition types. So basically, condition type is nothing but your output type.
Yeah.
Because we are dealing with outputs. Okay, and next step is we are assigning the output types with the access sequence. Okay, and finally we will maintain the procedure, output procedure. PRCGY. Okay, and assign all the output types. So this is nothing but your condition technique, what we normally use either in SGMM or any other modules, PP. PP is different, but SGMM.
Maybe, yeah, to the document types.
Yeah, output procedure will be assigned again back to your document types for SG, document. Sales order, delivery or billing. But condition technique, this is the logic. What we are talking about the condition technique is this. And if you want to trigger, determine this output type into the document types, we assign this in the document type. So that's how the condition technique will work for determining the output in the building. But going forward, we are not using the condition technique. In the sense, we are using a BRF. So we are not going to use in the sense for certain output types. Like for example, my transmission medium. Okay. Say I have a ZRD0. This is for my billing. Okay. This is for billing output type. And I want to print it from the billing. Okay. And my requirement is I want to send also email also. Okay. And also I want to give say fax. Okay. In this case, what happens? One output type if I want to give for a print, and same output type if I want to go for a mail, or if same output type if I want to go for a fax. So system in ECC does not allow. Why? Because say for example, I already attach a print. Okay. And second time, if I am going to try a determine ZRDO, it will say so already one output type is available and it will go on inactive mode. The same time, and if I want to go for fax, then also it will not allow. So what we have to do for in ECC is we need to create maybe ZRD1 or ZRD2. Okay, so these are all the output types what we need to do for one each, one for print, one for email, and one for fax. Okay, and also say for example ZRDO, I want to give a print to customer. My business partner is sold to party or payer. Same print I want to give it for end user also, or same print I want to send it for sales employee, or same print I want to send it for somebody else. So what we will be doing, we cannot do it by default, okay, in the standard. So either we need to go for a routine or we need to create a new output type. So maybe we need to give multiple prints, okay, or we need to send for multiple printers. So those are all not available as per the standard SAP in the ECC version. And if at all we need to do, we need to create a multiple output types. That's all. But in the S/4HANA system, the same requirement can be addressed using a BRF. So what is the main advantage is when I have a single output type, if I want to send it for multiple customers or multiple transmission mediums, which is not possible in my ECC system. So this can be done in a flexible manner in the BRF. So BRF is business rules framework. It's basically called as a business rules framework. So when we are talking about a BRF plus, it's completely on the NetWeaver platform. Okay, we are not maintaining anything in the S4HANA. All my condition records or all my determination processor, everything we are going to do it in the BRF, okay, which is a NetWeaver platform. It's just an interface built from your S4HANA backend system to the BRF. So that's why BRF can be created in NetWeaver platform. Either it can be work for both on-premise as well as the cloud versions. Okay, so another important thing is, before you go for any implementation project and when you are doing a business blueprint meetings or gap analysis, so you need to identify whether the customer is using the NACE condition type for email, for IDOC process, or for fax, or for some technical task IDs. So there are some values in the NACE transactions which BRF is not supporting currently. So for example, the current transmission mediums which BRF supports is only the print. IDOC, okay, and email. So it will not support the fax. It will not support, task, any special functions. Okay, and any events, or it will not support any other whatever is available. There are total 9 or 10 which SAP supports, but here currently we are only having a 3 which SAP supports in S4HANA system. I will show you what are those. So when your client says, okay, I need to send a fax or I need to send a task ID for event to some different systems. So in such case, SAP gives a functionality as a provision that you can go with the NACE only condition technique, don't go for BRF. And also, if you activate BRF plus for a certain application, maybe say I want billing documents to be sent for BRF. Okay, I activated all my billing transactions to be sent using a BRF. And once you activate, it is very difficult for us to come back into the normal NACE transaction. Okay, initially, say for example, you went for some business requirements and you told to customer, okay, we will activate a BRF plus for your business. And after you go inside, because you did not do any deep dive analysis, but after you go inside the system and identified, okay, there are some transmission mediums, so like fax, and they are sending some fax to some customers or business partners using a billing. Initially, we did not identify. So then after you start doing, okay, customer comes and says, okay, I don't know it. I also want this to be sent to a fax, also to be sent to some of the business partners. So in such case, if you activated BRF plus for which a business transmission medium is not available, it is very difficult for us to roll back into the NACE. So before we go and activate a BRF plus, we should think twice whether the customer requirement is meeting using a BRF or not. If it is not meeting, so let them go with only a NACE. So that's a major, currently the drawback. Maybe we are going forward, we can see it also will be inbuilt. But till now, till 1909, it's not available.
This is based on the specific sales organization also can be done, or?
No, application.
It's only application.
Yeah, it's only on application. Say for example, I am into a ECC system, say for B1 sales.
Okay.
So I'll go to the output type. Okay, so we have LD00 something and processing routines. Yeah, this are all we have. Print, fax, telex, external send, EDA, simple mail, special functions, events, situation, tasks. So currently we have a print.
You mean, sir, like, you know, currently this output type LD00 is migrated to BRF plus, so we cannot roll out back, right?
Yeah, once it is already there in your S4HANA system with the BRF, it is very difficult for us to roll back into the NACE transaction. We need to have a different, functionalities.
Okay, so that's what. So important point is, under application, only output type. We're talking about only specific output type. not a
company. No, under application, we are activating the BRF complete for shipping. Not on the output type. We don't have any output types there. So only application level we are activating. So I'll show you the transaction, but just to make you understand, I take you to the next transaction. Okay, see, for example, this is a fax. They want to send a fax also, the delivery note. But you will check with the business whether this is required in your S4 system, how frequent you're sending. And business says, okay, this is also one of the requirement. So then you don't go with the BRF. Don't activate application V2 for BRF. You need to go only with your needs.
So basically, if I have 10 outputs that are in operational, for V2, let's say.
Your
voice is not clear.
Yeah. Is it okay now?
Yeah, I'm better.
Okay. Yeah, okay. So let's say, for example, we have for V2, we have 10 outputs in operational, and for one output, let's say it is using event as a medium. Then entire 10 outputs we should not consider for BRF, right?
Now here we are not going based on the output type. It's only based on the application in BRF.
Exactly. This is my question. So
yeah. So we are not going based on the output type. It's only on the application.
And what about the current functionality migration from ECC to HANA?
ECC to HANA. If this functionality is available in your S4 HANA also, because
no, what
limitations. Okay.
No, my question is about from migration point of view, what is going to happen in both the cases? Let's say, for example, take V2 as an example. So the one case, let's say, 10 outputs. Again, I'm taking the same example. 10 outputs are, let's say, using print fax. Sorry, print this email and IDOC. Only those 10. And if this is the case, what is the approach to be followed for the migration?
Yeah, correct.
This is the first point. And the second point is, let's say out of 10, I have only one output type which is which is on event based, and if that is the case, then how to proceed?
Yeah, see, I'll explain you. So normally when you are only using a print external send or the email functionality which is available in S4 HANA system. So let me just go into the S4, into the output. So this is in the cross application component output control. Okay, so this is a place where I'm going to activate my BRF. So for this is the first place. So for goods movement, for scheduling document, for billing sales orders, this is application. So let's say, for example, I will go for sales orders. Sales documents, okay. So this is my sales document. And what is the status you are saying? You want this as a default or you want to activate? So just activate. Okay.
What is this default?
You want this as a default. Like you are using both S4 BRF, and you want to use for some of the sales document, you want to use say NACE transaction actually, but it's in initial setting, which is in 1.5.11. There we have completely S4 has come up with only the BRF, so they did not thought about all the limitations, so they gave for one or two versions as a default. But now later it is only application active or inactive unit use. So if you say application is active, so that means I'm saying for my sales orders, I want to use only BRF. In this place, if you set as an active. So just see here, default is inactive now. So we cannot use default. Clear?
Can you show me once again?
So application active, application inactive, and default. Application active is this transaction is specifically for BRF activation. I'm saying for all my sales documents, application area sales. I say I want to activate a BRF.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so default is not there. So you have to compulsory use this as a only one source for outputs for entire sales documents. Either it can be sales acknowledgement or it can be a customer acknowledgement or anything. Whatever you are sending for any system, you have to only use this. Maybe you are using some print or you are sending external send or mail or some IDOCs which are going from outside. So anything, you need to activate only the BRF.
And why it is showing it as application inactive in this case?
This is for default.
No, I mean...
Status so is, this application is active. Default, there is no default now. Okay, so default is, if I say default, so that means by default, you have to use this as a option, but you can also have an option for output NACE transaction. But now we
can you click on the default once? Can you click on the default once?
So I cannot roll back because I already activated. I have not saved it, but I will just come out and do it default.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, sales document and status I'm doing. So default. Okay, this is already activated somewhere. This was already active. Okay, so let me do it for delivery or billing. To save it for billing. So let's take Nota Physical and I want to show it as a default. Okay. So what we are saying is Nota Physical, I'm just saying this is a default. Okay. And the system is saying it's inactive. Why it is showing inactive is because from 1709 onwards, we don't have a functionality called default. So once you save as something activated here in this transaction, system will think, okay, I need to go only for a BRF and I am not going for using a NACE, even though you have a condition records maintained. Okay, is it clear?
I'm still, okay.
So if I say inactive, so just forget about this default. This default has no significance now.
Okay,
this is only before 1610. So you have only these options, active or inactive. Active is I'm going to use BRF. Inactive is I'm going to use NACE.
Okay.
Okay. Note physical. Okay, sales document is already active, application active, and there is nothing to be as a default or nothing. You say when it is active, I'm not going to use any condition records from NACE. Okay, this is already saved. So this is an important functionality or significance we have when we are dealing with the initial kickoff meetings. So we need to understand, once it is active, I cannot set it back. Okay, if I want to set it back, so that means I want to deactivate it, I need to go seek the help of SAP only. We as implementation partner or any consultants, they cannot do. There are a lot of voices notes. They need to be...
If you try to make it inactive, what is the message it provides?
It says, just try to save it.
Okay, at this moment it allows us.
Yeah, it is allowing, but actually in the backend it is, it will not look for any NACE transaction.
No, now it's currently inactive. So which means it will by default go to NACE?
No, actually once you activate, it will not go back into the NACE. It will only look for a BRF.
Uh-huh.
So okay. This is only just for once it is activated, our role won't be there anything. Only the SAP should pitch in and say they need to run so many backend reports to make it a completely application as an inactive. So that means I don't want to use a BRF again anymore.
are we going to see that rolling back functionality?
No, that's the OSS nodes are there. I'll show you the OSS nodes, OSS nodes we need to run, but those also we cannot run it. The authorization is only still with the SAP. So even your implementation partner is trying to do it, so they cannot do it on their own. Okay, those nodes are only properly authorized by SAP. So this is sensitive transaction. So we need to think twice before you activate or deactivate. Okay, so what are the output types you want to define? So here we don't need to define multiple output types, one per application. Okay, say for example, I have a sales application object type is sales and distribution. So what we have? Yeah, so this is my sales document types. I'm not going to define anything with the ZDR0, Z100. Like this, I'm not going to define. So I have defined as a cash sales, one output type, okay, and a contracts, one output type. So actually, it is not required for many output types also. Only one sales document type is enough. Okay, so this this is, since a demo system, I think if somebody has defined like this, but normally we use only one-to-one. And if at all you have something with to differentiate, you can differentiate. But normally we don't need to create these many. One-to-one is enough. Let's say for building documents, you have anything. Yeah, see now, building document, I have only building. Okay, even if it's a nota fiscal or if it is say pro forma invoice or commercial invoice or external taxes, tax invoice, everything we can configure using this. So how, you may have a doubt, like how do I differentiate whether it's a commercial invoice or pro forma invoice? So it depends on your document type.
So I have one more doubt. So this, how do system know that this billing underscore document is V3?
Billing underscore document, you are saying application?
Yes.
Inside the application object, it will be available. This is a class, you need to go inside technically and see.
Okay.
So anybody knows the debugging or program, how to read it, we can see.
Maybe Santosh knows. Okay.
Third public. So this is going inside the class. Maybe we need to go to method.
There might be somewhere some attribute might have made.
Yeah, so that's whether it's a V3 or V1, we need to find out. So what will be the application? You know what is the application in ACC system in the NIS?
V3.
It is V3.
V3.
This field. KAAPL, this is that element. Field is also KAPPL. In full class, I'm searching. So let's see. Yeah, here it is going.
So it's a get method, I guess.
Get method.
Get legacy data method.
Yeah.
Okay.
These are all APIs. So in case if you want to get something from your S4HANA system, ECC to S4HANA system, this method will be called.
And it is also referencing to individual
only one output.
Output. So it looks like in case if we want to add a new output types, we need to add it. We need to add it in this class level, I guess.
Yeah. So for example, you have a Z output types. So all mm-hmm. things to be mapped into the building output, you need to do it. Yes.
So that means that we are not only configuring the outputs, but also referencing it in classes also to pick those.
Yeah, this role when you are doing only migration, but normally we won't do all those things. When you are doing a migration from ECC to S4, right, it will be by default call all the configuration in case if you want to use BRF.
In case if I wanted to create a new output in S4 HANA,
this is not required. In case if you want to create, this is only just to migrate your legacy system data into the S4, you need to use this.
Okay.
But this role will be taken care during the migration of complete configuration from ECC to the S4. They will take care of everything. Or in case you want to only do on your own without any implementation partner, so yes, we need to come here and modify something. But I don't know whether this is allowed or not. Maybe we have some enhancement points. We can write it. Mm-hmm. Okay. So these are the classes what we have. And
So basically these are the APIs which will help pulling up the legacy data or settings, whatever it may be.
Correct, yeah. All and configuration also they are moving, like not only the master data, even configuration. When they migrate one system to another system, we cannot do the complete configuration again in S4, right? We have a lot of data configured already. It was almost running from 10 years. So those kind of configuration, if you want to do manually, it will take a lot of time. It will consume a lot of time. So what SAP has come up with? They come up with the APIs. So if I want to migrate complete system into the S4, so till 1709, it is taking a lot of time, 2 months, 3 months to configure everything. But after 1709, because of this flexibility, give the system to SAP by Friday. By Monday when you come, your S4 and our system, the configuration will look similar to your ECC.
Okay,
yes, some we need to modify.
So basically, okay. So my doubt here is that this APIs, interface APIs, these are different to individual or different applications, or it is one and the same for all the applications?
No, it is different to different applications. From say, sales, we have a different APIs. For services, we have different. For plant maintenance, we have different. And also application to application is different. Object to object.
And do we have the list of APIs that are used for different applications? Let's say, again, this question is folded with two sub questions. One is what are the different APIs used for different applications? Let's say sales related, I'm looking at for. And the second one is individual API, let's say individual application, V3 billing. Okay, take the example as V3 as billing. And if billing is migrating, then what are the different APIs used for different activities? Let's say one API is used for pulling up the data, one API is used to used for pulling up the configurations, and so on.
No, that detail I don't have. It is either above or basis can help.
Maybe if you have any documentation, that also would be fine.
Yeah, I will see. Because I never did in direct migration, I am not there. So I went only from the master data migration. From complete system, I am not there. So I know how to find the APIs, but complete list I don't have. I can try.
Okay. Basically, you understood my question, right?
Yeah, I understand.
Okay.
See, this APS is nothing but your RFC. In your ECC, when you are using the RFC or XAE process, right? PIXAE process orchestration. The same functionality, we are having it in the as an enhanced version, which is APIs.
So this RFC is nothing but TRFC.
TRFC, yes. And this APIs, we have a multiple, like one is a cloud HCI, and also we have something called as a CPI. Okay, so HCI is HANA Cloud Interface, where I have a S4HANA system, and I'm also having something called as Ariba system. So if I want to interface these two, I will be using HCI. So later on, this was converted into CPI, Cloud Platform Interface. Okay. It's clear, right?
The first one you said hybrid.
HANA Cloud Interface, HCI.
HANA. And what is the difference between these two?
No, it's only just simply from PO, PI, XI, PI, PO, the advanced. HCI is converted into CPI now.
Okay.
Okay, something advanced. So they made it some flexible and they brought it as a CPIs, Cloud Platform Interface.
Okay.
So this is a business rules for output automation. This we will see in some time. Okay, so this next is assign output channels. Yeah, so these are all the channels for my billing document. What channels I have? Yeah, they added few more. Email, EDA also they added. IDOC, print, XML also they added. So previously, print output is there. IDOC and email. Now XML and EDA also they added. So going forward, I think 2020, you will get remaining also. So once we get a system, we can come to know. Okay.
So I have one more question. So, yeah. So basically, just now, I mean, 10 minutes back, we discussed that once it is activated, whether it is, we can activate it either it for NACE or S4HANA functionalities, right? Is this just only for migration purpose, or it is also...
This configuration is you need to do. This is only BRF. You don't see this in the ECC. No migration in this case.
No, my question is about S4HANA. This is activated in S4HANA, right?
Yeah. Correct.
So once this is activated, this is only active till the migration happens, or it is also active after migration too?
So this is normal when you want to create anything new of BRF for some other document types, like we have activated for billing, but later you want to do it for some sales orders. That configuration you need to make here.
Why I asked this question is that I mean, just now we saw that get data method in billing, right? So usually get data from legacy is helpful for migration. So yeah, I'm just thinking how it will be used in the current functionality.
No, that's understand. So that's what in current APIs system is not supporting if you are having a task or special functions. We have seen, right? Because in the configuration itself, I don't see a task and special functions. In your legacy, if you are using a task and special function as one of the medium. So SAP says we don't have anything such functionality in S4. You better use only NACE. So then in that case, there is no migration concept, right? I don't need to activate for that application.
And what if I used a task in my ECC and I do not want to use it in...
Only for NACE.
No. My question is, task is existing in ECC, okay. But I do not want to use it in S4HANA.
Okay. So then you don't migrate that object.
Okay.
So you are only doing it for email or print or any other functionality, XML, EDA, IDOC, whatever is existing.
So basically, it is a beauty of your Excel file or loading file. in which you have to restrict.
No, this is a system SLT method. You are not doing using the Excel. It's a system landscape transformation where you will be having a plugins from like a C to the S4.
Then how to restrict the data?
It will not come. When you are having